There's been a new study from the peer-reviewed medical literature on bone fractures in vegans that's from the EPIC Oxford study, looking at a cohort of British vegans. Now, this was the second largest study on vegans in human history, and worryingly, researchers found that vegans have a higher bone fracture risk. In fact, are 43% more likely to suffer bone fractures. We need to take this really seriously. So firstly, vegans have been found in previous research to have a lower bone mineral density than meat eaters. So let's unpack that first. Now, in prior research in 2007, that difference disappears when you control for body mass index. This is because heavier people have stronger bones. The reason for this is because they are essentially doing weight-bearing exercise when they just walk around their house. If you go out running and you bear some weight down on your skeleton gets stronger. So actually being overweight is like having a 40 to 100 pound backpack on all the time. And so their skeleton gets really strong. That's why those who are obese have a higher bone mineral density. Also, the extra padding on the body makes it harder to break a bone when you fall, and vegans tend to be slimmer on average. So in the previous research, what happens when you compare meat eaters and vegans at the same weight? Well, that difference in bone mineral density disappears. Also, in the original EPIC Oxford study, vegans had a higher risk of wrist fractures, as opposed to vertebral or hip fractures. And according to Dr. Greger, this wasn't necessarily due to osteoporotic bone, but could have been put down to those who are more active, do more sport, etc. They can have a higher incidence of wrist fractures. But again, in the original study, in 2007, this higher wrist fracture difference disappeared when the researchers controlled for calcium intake. They found that when vegans were getting more than 525 milligrams of calcium a day, they did not have higher rates of bone fractures. Good sources of calcium are sesame seeds, calcium set tofu, kale, collards, bok choy, and calcium fortified plant milks. So is the simple answer to this latest article published in 2020 is that they're just not getting enough calcium? Sadly not. Let's hear now from Dr. Michael Greger as he explains more.
The new EPIC Oxford study, they still found excess fracture rates even after controlling for calcium intake and even after controlling for bone mineral density. So the question is, okay, now what's going on? So there's a number of hypotheses that the investigators reached out. So for example, protein intake, IGF-1, this cancer-promoting growth hormone, when you eat a lot of protein, you increase your IGF-1 levels. And so you can increase certain types of cancer. But it is a growth hormone and can cause bone growth as well. But that's unlikely to be the case because plant-based protein associated with much stronger bones than animal. So plant-based protein like beans associated with much denser bones, stronger bones than animal-based protein like meat. So that doesn't seem to make sense. What about vitamin K? Well, vitamin K comes from dark green leafy vegetables, but that's vitamin K1. There's another type of vitamin K called vitamin K2. That's found mostly in animal products like meat and dairy. Could that be what's going on? Well, there's actually never been good evidence that there's any difference between the activities of K1 and K2. So K1 should do everything that K2 does, but it doesn't matter. Why? Because we make all the K2 we want. We have an enzyme discovered in 2010 that just creates K2. No reason to take vitamin K2. And so that's not the problem either. Probably more likely vitamin D. So this was in Great Britain. We'd like to get our vitamin D levels up to about probably ideally 75 nanomoles per liter, which is like 30 nanograms per milliliter, depending on what kind of units you use. And vegans totally nail that in the summer because it's the sunshine vitamin. But during the winter months, and we're creeping into that, vegans dip down. In the UK, they're at such a high latitude, the sun's rays are at such an angle, that vegans dip down like below 40. So that's like less than like 15 nanograms per milliliter. And that's because they're not eating food sources of vitamin D. The vegans are dipping low enough on vitamin D that may play a role. Although at the same time, you know, if you do randomized controlled trials giving people vitamin D, and increasing levels, you don't see a benefit in fracture risk. So then that would kind of argue against the vitamin D hypothesis. However, you give them calcium and vitamin D together, you can decrease fracture rates. So it may actually be a combination of the fact that vegans in Great Britain dip too low during the winter months and may have inadequate calcium intake. And that combination is what's causing these excess fractures. Or, you know, it could actually be B12. There's a recent systematic review. You know, they don't supplement organic foods in the UK by law with B12, like the soy milk and plant-based meat and things that would normally have B12 here in the States, doesn't have any B12. And so if you're not supplementing it, you're probably not getting it. The vitamin B12 deficiency rates among vegans in London is really off the charts. But this latest systematic review on B12 and bone suggests it's really kind of complicated, the relationship between bone and B12. But complicated is my middle name. That's what you pay me for. That's what you make donations to nutritionfacts.org, the 501c3 nonprofit, to do the deep digging and figure out. So I'm going to do a deep dive, and just like I did with the stroke data, and to come up with series of videos and figure out what's going on with the new data.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment below and subscribe for more upcoming videos.